Hello students, welcome to the 41st lecture in linear algebra. In this video lecture we will be discussing the topic that is orthogonal projection, and the four topics will be covered in this video lecture, that is the orthogonal projection. Second one will be the uniqueness of orthogonal projection. Third is how to find orthogonal projections, and the last is the orthogonal decomposition. So let us begin with what is an orthogonal projection, right? So orthogonal projection. So the basic meaning is projection means the shadow, right? So what is the shadow of that vector on any given plane, right? So let me consider for this. So let us consider the orthogonal projection, of the vector x coming from R cube, right? So to a subspace of R cube when W is x axis, right? Then what will be the projection of this x, which is nothing but x, y, z transpose, right? So what will be the projection of this? So clearly this is a vector, right? And when you take the projection of this vector on x axis, that will only come out to be x 0 0. So can I write it down like x 1 0 0? And what is my 1 0 0? That is a standard basis. So x times x dot e1 multiply with e1. So can I say this thing? Similarly, if my w comes out to be xy plane, and what is the projection in this case of xyz? So that is x y 0. And in this case, you can write it down x into 1 0 0 plus y times 0 1 0, right? So now furthermore you can write it down like x dot with e1 multiply with e1 plus x dot with e2 multiply with e2. So that is the intuitive idea how we check the projection of this. Now let me formally define the orthogonal projection so as to make you things more clear. So the formal definition for this, we'll consider W to be any linear subspace. So W be a linear subspace of Rn, and then you will consider any vector that is coming from Rn, that is let x come from Rn. So what is the orthogonal projection? That is what we are considering, right? So if, see, this is my, so let me draw it here. So if this is my subspace, I have called this as W, right? Now if this is any arbitrary vector x, fine with this. Now I want the orthogonal projection. So it means I have to draw a vector in this direction and this direction. Fine with this. So this is the projection. That is, if you see from O to B, this will be the projection of OA vector, right? That is a y. So if for this, now let me write it. So W be a linear subspace of Rn, and x you have considered to be any vector in Rn, then a vector y, right? So this is a vector y, you can see in the figure in W. So a vector y in W such that x minus y is perpendicular to W. So what is this x minus y? This is nothing but AB. You can just visualize this, that this AB vector is nothing but normal to this subspace. Now even you can just check it out, how I can write it down like x minus y, because if you apply the triangles law in this OAB, triangles law, right? So OB plus AB is equals to OA, right? So what is my AB? AB is nothing but OA minus OB. Right, what is my OA? That is x. What is this? Y. So AB comes out to be nothing but x minus y. So can I say this x minus y is perpendicular to this subspace W, right? So if W is my linear subspace of Rn and x is any vector coming from Rn, so this vector y is called the projection, right? So this vector is called the orthogonal projection. So orthogonal projection of this vector x to the W. And when I will say this is a orthogonal projection, if x minus y, so that is such that x minus y is perpendicular to this subspace, right? So if my x minus y is perpendicular to this subspace W, so there is a notation which I will generally call, that is this x minus y, this will go to, so I will say that x minus y belongs to W perpendicular, that is a perpendicular subspace, right? So final result, what is the result? What is the conclusion? Conclusion is whenever my x minus y is perpendicular to w. So this is if and only if my x minus y belongs to w perpendicular, right? Now let me consider an example for this. So example, so let w be a non-zero vector and x is any vector coming from Rn, right? And let y be the orthogonal projection of x to the line that is spanned by w. Y is characterized by, so y will come from w, right? And x minus y, so see this x minus y, right? If you take the dot with w is any vector, so that will come out to be zero because it's perpendicular and right to this space. So whenever you take the dot product of this will automatically comes out to be zero. Now since y belongs to the span of w, right? So can I say y is some r times w for some scalar r, right? Of course coming from field, and the field is r I have considered here, right? So see this. So what is my zero? Zero is nothing but x minus y dot with w from this one equation, right? Now just separate these terms. So this will be x dot w, right, minus y dot w. And what is the value of y? That is r times w. Just substitute the value here. I think up to this the steps are clear. So this is x dot w minus r times w dot with w, right, which yields that, so this is equals to zero. So can I say that this r is equals to, so just bring the terms on one side, r into w dot with w is equals to x dot w, and what is the value of r? So this is x dot w divided by w dot with w. Fine with this? So that is the value of r. And what were we interested? We were interested to calculate the value of y. Why? Because why we were interested to calculate the value of y? Because the y is the orthogonal projection of x to this subspace, and we want to know the value of y. So what was my y? We have considered the y to be, right, r times w. So just substitute it here, r times w. What is the value of r? X dot w divided by w dot w multiply with w. So this is the value of r, right? And already I know that what is my w dot with w? That is nothing but norm of w square, right, multiply with w. So that is the value of y. Now conversely, if I say that the vector is given by the formula, so the vector y given by above formula certainly satisfies that y belongs to w and x minus y dot with w is zero, right? So which gives rise to orthogonal projection, right? Now let me consider an example for this. So for example, so if w is nothing but my 1 1 1, right, 1 1 1, right, and x is any arbitrary vector, that is x, y and z, right, and we want to calculate the projection of x, right? So that is nothing but y is equals to, right, x dot w divided by w dot w multiply with w. So just take the dot product of x and w, so this comes out to be x plus y plus z. And what is the w dot with w? That is 3. And what is the vector w? That is 1, 1, 1. So now we discuss the uniqueness of orthogonal projection. That is, I want to prove that the orthogonal projection is always unique. So the theorem dealing with this is, so let me write the theorem. So if w is a linear subspace, w be a linear subspace of Rn, and again you will consider any vector x coming from Rn, right? Then the orthogonal projection right? That is of x to the w is unique. That is what we are interested to prove, right? So let me directly go to the proof, right? So for this, let y prime and y double prime be the orthogonal projections. So I will be considering two distinct orthogonal projections, and finally I have to prove that both of them are equal, right? So let they be the orthogonal projections of x to the subspace that is y, right? Now what we are interested to prove, so we are, what we want to prove, that y prime is nothing but y double prime. If we show this, so finally we can say that the orthogonal projection is unique. For this, let me consider, so let me set z prime equals to x minus y prime and z double prime equals to x minus y double prime. So students, you can easily see this. So this is, if this is was my subspace as I have described above, and this is my vector x, right? So the projection of this vector, right? So that is y prime in first case and the y prime in the another case. So, and what is this? This is nothing but my x minus y prime. So in the first case you have considered as z prime, and in the other case you will be considering as a z double prime. So that is how I have set this z prime and z double prime. So I hope this thing is clear to you now. So this implies x is equals to z prime plus y prime, and x is equals to z double prime plus y double prime. So x is equals to both of these things. So this implies z prime plus y prime has to be equal to z double prime plus y double prime. Or can I say y prime minus y double prime is equals to z double prime minus z prime, right? And now you should observe one thing. So since y prime and y double prime, they were coming from W, right? And W is a subspace. So this implies y prime minus y double prime will also come from W, right? And since what was my z prime? Z prime was x minus y prime, right? And z double prime was x minus y double prime, right? And both of these, z prime and z double prime, they belongs to W perpendicular subspace, right? So again, W perp, and W perp we have already proved that this is a subspace. So this implies z double prime minus z prime must belongs to W perpendicular. Fine with this? Now you should observe that here is the equality. Now one side belongs to W and the other side belongs to W perp. So this implies that the above equality will only hold, right, when W intersection W perp is nothing but zero. And if W intersection W perp is zero, right, so what does this implies? This implies that y, so they have to be equal to zero. So y prime equals to y double prime and z prime equals to z double prime, and hence uniqueness is proved. So let me repeat it once again for you. So since here it was equality, one side was belonging to W, the other side was belonging to W perp, so they have nothing in common except zero, right? So that is the common between the two subspaces. So finally, y prime minus y double prime and z double prime minus z prime, they have to be equal to zero. And if my y primes comes out to be equal to y double prime, and that is how we have, you know, proved the uniqueness. So the next topic is finding the orthogonal projections. For this, let me consider w1, w2 up till wk, right? They forms an orthogonal basis. Then the orthogonal projection of the vector x, right, to w is given by, already we have described the above formula, right? And now we can write the formula in the summation form. So y comes out to be equal to summation I running from 1 to k x dot with w, right, wi, right, wi dot with wi multiply with wi. And you can furthermore write it down, that is a summation I running from 1 to k x dot wi, and what is wi dot with wi? That is norm of wi square multiply with wi. So that is the formula, right? So since y is a linear combination, linear So you can see y is summation times wi, right? So something times w1 plus something times w2 plus something times w3 up till so on to something time wk. So can I say y is a linear combination? Linear combination of w1, w2 up till so on to wk, right? So it belongs to w, right? So now if you calculate x minus y dot with wj, so what does it comes out to be? So it comes out to be x minus, what is the value of y? Y is summation I running from 1 to k, right? X dot wi divide by wi dot with wi multiply with wi and whole dot with wj. Now just club the terms. So this is x dot wj minus summation I running from 1 to k x dot wi divide by wi dot with wi and wi dot with wj. And in the beginning we have considered wi is to be the orthogonal basis, right? So if they are the orthogonal basis, so you will apply the property of orthogonal basis. So since they are the orthogonal, so whenever my I is equal to j, so in that case it will be as it is, and all other cases it will come out to be zero. So since they are orthogonal, so it means xi dot with xj, they are, that is equal to zero. Fine. So whenever my I will equal to be j, so whenever my I will be equal to j, only that vector will be left. So this will be x dot wj divide by wj dot with wj into wj dot with wj. In all other cases it will come out to be zero in rest of the cases. Fine with this. And now just you can see, so this will get cancelled out and these terms will also get cancelled out, and finally you are left with zero, right? So for all j, this is true for all j that is coming from 1 till k. Fine with this. So you have proved that my x minus y dot with wj, that is equal to zero. Now what if, so the one remark before we conclude this, so what if when my u1, u2 up till uk, they forms onb. So if they forms an onb, so in that case, what do we have? So y will come out to be equal to summation, because in that case, the norm will come out to be 1. So I running from 1 to k, right? X dot ui and multiply with ui, fine. Now why this thing is true? Because we know that because ui dot with ui is equals to 1 for all I. Right, for I running from 1 to k. So that is why this thing is true. Now let's see. Now let's see for k equals to 1, what the above formula becomes. So it will be equal to x dot w, right? W1 divide by W1 dot W1 multiply with W1. And if my W1 is 1, 1, 1, as I have considered above, and my x vector is x, y, z. So in that case, you can see that my y vector will come out to be equal to x plus y plus z divided by 3 multiply with 1, 1 and 1. For k equals to 2, so what does the above formula become? So the above formula becomes y equals to x dot w1 divided by w1 dot w1 multiply with w1 plus x dot w2 divided by w2 dot with w2 multiply with w2, right? And in the similar way, you can consider w1 to be 1 minus 1 and 0, fine. W2 that is equals to 1, 1 and minus 2. So students, you should recall that these WIs, they should be orthogonal bases, and you can check that this is an orthogonal basis, right? W1 dot with W2 is equals to 0. So since W1, W2 are orthogonal, so they are orthogonal, so you can calculate the projection, right? And we have written the formula in above, right? So y comes out to be x dot with w1. So in that case it will be x minus y, right, divide by the norm of w1, so the norm of w1 square, that is a 2, multiply with w1, that is 1 minus 1 and 0, fine. X dot with w2 will come out to be x plus y minus 2z divide by the norm square of w2, that comes out to be 6, right, and multiply with 1 minus 1, so 1, 1 and minus 2. And finally, if you solve these equations, so finally what will be the answer? So the answer will be 1 by 3 common. So 2x minus y minus z minus x plus 2y minus z, and the final will be minus x minus y plus 2z. So that will be the final answer if you calculate the above things. So the fourth topic for the day is orthogonal decomposition, right? Again for this, so very simple topic actually. So let W be a linear subspace. Linear subspace of Rn, and again let x be any vector that is coming from Rn, right? And you, as we consider y to be the, so y be the orthogonal projection of this vector x, right, to the subspace W, then the vector y and z. What was my z? That is x minus y. So this satisfy a property. So this satisfy, that is, you can say that x is equals to y plus z, where my y is coming from W and z is coming from W perpendicular. So you have, you know, decomposed this vector x into two parts, where the first part is coming from W and the second part is coming from W perpendicular, right? So such an expression is called the orthogonal decomposition of x with respect to the subspace W. Fine with this? So before we conclude this lecture, let me add a remark. So the previous formulas were, what is the orthogonal projection, right, of this vector to the subspace W? What if I get, find the orthogonal projection of this x to the subspace that is a perpendicular subspace, that is W perpendicular. For this, let me consider W to be a linear subspace of Rn and W perpendicular, that is the orthogonal complement of in Rn, right? And x be any vector that is coming from Rn. Now you consider the orthogonal projection z of x to the W perpendicular subspace. So clearly you can see, so this is my vector is x, right? And this is my vector y. So this will be x minus y from the triangle's law. Now just complete the triangle which I have marked with the pink color, right? So this will be z. So this will be BA. So what will be my BA? That will be x minus, right? So x minus z. Fine with this? So if I say my z is coming from W perpendicular, so what is my x minus y? That is my z. So z belongs to W perpendicular. Yes, this thing is true. So my x minus z, so that is a vector which is, you know, parallel to y. So can I say this x minus z is perpendicular to this subspace W perpendicular? Right. So the same intuition is clear. So that is then the vector y. So what is my vector y? That is x minus z. So this agrees with the orthogonal projection. So this agrees with the orthogonal projection of x to W. So can I say that my y belongs to W, right? And x minus y is perpendicular to W. Fine with this? So therefore, if W1 up till so on to Wk, they are the set of orthogonal bases of W. So what will be the formula? The formula will be z equals to x minus y. And we know that what is my y? Y is nothing but the summation, right? I running from 1 to k x dot wi divide by wi dot with wi multiply with wi. So this gives me the orthogonal projection. So this gives me the orthogonal projection of x to the perpendicular subspace, that is a W perp, right? So what is the W perp? That is the orthogonal complement of W. So I hope this formula is clear to you now. So what is the formula final? Final formula is this one. So if you want to calculate the orthogonal projection of, if you want to calculate the orthogonal projection of X to the perpendicular subspace, and what if you want to calculate normal projection of the vector X, right? So for that, you know, what is the formula? The formula is given here. So let me mark it again. So that is y equals to summation this, right, x dot wi divided by the norm of wi square into wi. So I hope all these four topics which I have discussed in this video lecture, that is orthogonal projection, right, and the second one is the uniqueness of orthogonal projection, then the finding orthogonal projection and orthogonal decomposition. I hope these four topics are clear to you now. In the upcoming video lectures, we will be exploring few more concepts, right? And I hope you have enjoyed this video session. For more such videos, do subscribe to my YouTube channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. Thank you so much, students. Thank you.